Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Good morning, students. In this session, we are going to discuss another important formation of the coordination compound from the VBT theory. Already in my previous session, I completed octahedral complexes formation based on the VBT theory. Okay, so in this session, based on the VBT theory, remaining tetrahedral complexes formation and square planar complexes formation. You know that very well, my dear students, the coordination number 6 present in any coordination compound that is show octahedral manner. So similarly, 4 coordination compounds, coordination number compounds also can be existed another different type of the structures, that is tetrahedral complexes and square planar complexes. So in this session, 4 coordination number of coordination compound, how to form the tetrahedral complexes and square planar complexes based on the valency bond theory. Okay, na? Already in my previous session, I successfully completed octahedral complexes formation based on the VBT theory. Now in this session, tetrahedral complexes and square planar complexes. So the first example from the tetrahedral complexes, my dear students, important point is, if any one of the complexes involved in the tetrahedral complexes, they are formed by sp3 hybridization. So definitely tetrahedral complexes contain sp3 hybridization. Here see some examples are there: tetraamine nickelate 2 and tetra carbonyl nickelate and tetrachloro nickelate 2 minus and tetrachloro cuprate 2 minus. These are all examples are the belongings to the category of tetrahedral complexes formation. But all tetrahedral complexes should be show sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization. Okay, nana? So that is the most important one, nana. See here, the first example from the tetrahedral complexes formation, nickel carbonyl, NiCO taken 4, nickel carbonyl, it is a neutral complexes, that's why there is no any net charge on the compound. That is the most important, Anna. So already this is a CBSE example, nickel carbonyl. See, Anna, in this complex, central nickel atom is attached to 4 CO ligands. Central nickel atom is attached to 4 CO ligands. The oxidation state of the nickel here 0. Nickel atom has the configuration 3d8 4s2. So in this presence of strong ligands, rearrangement takes place and the 4s electrons are forced to go into the 3d orbital. Thus nickel can now provided 4s and 4p orbital for the hybridization. One 4s and 3 4p orbital undergoes sp3 hybridization and form 4 hybrid orbital of equal energy, which are direct towards to 4 corners of the regular tetrahedral manner. Now see carefully here, nickel atomic number. Nickel, this is the valency configuration 3d 4s 4p. How many electrons are present in the 3d orbital? See here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 3d8 4s2. This is the valency electronic configurations of the nickel. So in the nickel valency shell, 3d orbital contains 8 electrons and 4s orbital contain 2 electrons. After that, what happened here? Rearrangement. Nickel atom, after the rearrangement of ligand CO, because of here oxidation state of the nickel 0, that's why here there is no eliminations of any electron from the 4s orbital. Here what happened, Nana? Nickel atom, after the rearrangement with ligands, rearrangement only possible here. Rearrangement only possible, na? See carefully here. This one here, these two electrons are come to the 3d orbital. Rearrangement, these two electrons are come to the 3d orbital, na? Apo already in the 3d orbital two unpaired electrons are there. These two unpaired electrons paired with 2 4s orbital electron. So here 4s orbital electrons are not eliminated because of nickel oxidation state here 0. That's why here rearrangement is possible. That is the most important, Nana. Nickel atom, after the rearrangement in the presence of the strong ligand CO. CO is a strong ligand. Whenever ligands are approaching to the central metal atom of the nickel can arrange rearrangement. Rearrangement means from the 4s orbital electron come to the joining into 3d orbital. Hence 3d orbital all electrons should be paired. So already in the ground state of the nickel electronic configuration, two unpaired electrons are there. After rearrangement of the electron, this 3d orbital completely paired. Clear, ma? So ipo completely paired na, NH here 4s orbitals are empty and 4p orbitals are empty. So now in the 3d orbital, the nickel completely paired with all electron. Hence, how many ligands are approaching to the nickel? 4 ligands are approaching to the ligand. 4 ligands are approaching to the nickel. That's why, my dear student, here nickel can be arranged 4 vacant orbital. So 1 orbital from the 4s orbital, 3 orbital from the 4p orbital. So this 4s orbital, one s orbital, this 3p orbital are intermixing to form new hybrid orbital. This is called sp3 hybrid orbital. So it's a most important point here. In my previous example, I clearly to explain, if any one of the central metal atom involved in the oxidation, what are the valence electron? That valence electrons are removed. But in this example, nickel carbonyl, it's a neutral complexes. In this nickel compound, nickel cannot show any kind of the oxidation state. Here oxidation state should be 0. That's why, my dear student, 4s orbital rearrangement possible. Whenever approaching to the 4 ligands to the central metal atom of the nickel, from 4s orbital electron completely transfer to the 3d orbital. Hence 3d orbital completely paired with the electron. Then the 4s orbitals are empty. Apo the 4s orbital or remaining 4p orbitals are involved in the hybridization, then to form new 4 hybrid orbital. That's called here 4 ligands are approaching to the central metal atom. That's why the central metal atom provided to the 4 new vacant orbital. So this 4 new vacant orbital. Okay, now so see carefully here. Now nickel atom, after the rearrangement in the presence of strong CO ligand, so now what happened? This completely paired and 4s orbital empty, 4p orbital empty. After that, what happened? Nana, this 4s orbital and this 3 4p orbital are intermixing, involved in the hybridization. This new 4sp3 hybrid orbitals are formed. So now see here, third statement, sp3 hybridization of nickel. So in the ground state there is no any difference, but here this 4 orbitals are connected together to form 4sp3 hybrid orbital. Aparama, how many ligands are approaching to the nickel? 4 ligands. So that 4 ligands are donated one lone pair of electron, that one lone pair of electron directly joining into the vacant orbital, that's why, my dear student, here sp3 hybrid orbital in nickel carbonyl, this is no changes, but now here what happened? Here 4 pairs of electron from the 4CO ligands, 4 pairs of electron from the 4CO ligands. So ultimately these compounds are existed. What is this compound name? Nickel carbonyl. What is the shape of this compound name? Tetrahedral complexes. This is the tetrahedral complexes. Now here, what is the hybridization? Nickel show 4 bonds, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bonds na, sp3 hybridization and a tetrahedral manner, and finally diamagnetic compounds. So why it's called diamagnetic compound, my dear students? Here in the central metal atom there is no any unpaired electron at ground state. That's why this compound nickel carbonyl act as a diamagnetic compound. Nickel carbonyl is act as a diamagnetic compound. This is the most important point, my dear students. So once again, from the formation of the tetrahedral complexes, especially nickel carbonyl, in the nickel carbonyl sp3 hybridization is possible, but in the nickel there is no show any kind of the oxidation state, zero oxidation state. That's why rearrangement of the electron from 4s orbital is possible. Hence 4 new hybrid orbitals are formed from the sp3 hybrid orbital. Hence tetrahedral manner shape is existed and the diamagnetic behavior. Why it's called diamagnetic behavior, my dear student? Here all electrons completely pair, there is no any unpaired electron. This is a formation of tetrahedral complexes nickel carbonyl. One example is enough, Nana, because of from the CBSE test book only gave one example. Now second, from coordination coordination number 4, one more category is there, that is called square planar complexes. Already clearly explained in my previous classes. So if any one of the coordination compound can existed, coordination number is 4, two different type of the structures are existed. Number 1 is tetrahedral complexes, number 2 is the square planar. From the tetrahedral complexes, nickel carbonyl example is the most important, already explained this one. And now from the square planar complexes, here coordination number is also 4, the but structure is a square planar structure. Now see, Nana, carefully here, square planar structure. Square planar complexes are formed by dsp2 hybridization. See, Nana, square planar complexes are formed by dsp2 hybridization. Examples here, see, Nana, example tetracyanonickelate 2, tetraamine cuprate 2 and tetrachloroplatinate 2, etc. example. But these three examples are there in CBSE test book. So the first example is a tetracyanonickelate 2 ion. So if any one of the coordination compound involved in the square planar complexes, what kind of the hybridization they can existed? DSP2 hybridization. DSP2 hybridization means the first d orbital are involved, then s orbital, next to 2p orbitals are involved. So that's why it's a DSP2 hybridization. Now see, Nana, here nickel tetranickelate 2 ion. In this complex, the oxidation state of the nickel plus 2. Nickel oxidation state plus 2 na, valence electron easily to remove. Okay na? So see carefully, in this complexes the oxidation state of the nickel is plus 2. Therefore the complexes consist of the central nickel 2 plus ion surrounded by 4 CN ligands. So now see carefully, my dear student. CN minus ligands are strong ligand and can pair up electron of nickel 2 plus. That is the most important, Nana. Pair up is possible in the center metal atom. Already I clearly explained in my previous session. If the ligands are weak ligand, central metal atom not pair up of the electron. If ligands are strong ligands, definitely central metal atom pair up of their unpaired electrons. Now here cyanide is a strong ligand, so CO is a strong ligand, CN is also strong ligand, but fluorine, water, amine are the weak ligands. So here in these complexes, 4 cyanide groups are approaching to the nickel, na upon nickel definitely to do pair up of the electrons. Why? Because strong ligands are approaching to the nickel. That's why in the nickel metal, in the nickel, definitely pair up is possible. Now see here, generally nickel atomic number, you know that very well. In the valence shell 3D, 3D 8 electrons are there, 3D 8 4s 2 the. In the 3D orbital, listen Nana, in the 3D orbital, what happened? Two unpaired electrons are there. After that, in this complex, nickel oxidation state is a plus 2. Nickel oxidation state is plus 2 mean nickel generally to lose the 2 electrons from 4s orbital. See here, already in the 4s orbital, 2 electrons are there. These 2 electrons are eliminated from the 4s orbital. Okay, na? Apo, in the nickel plus 2 ion, what is the electronic configuration? See, 3D, as usual 3D is there, there is no any difference. So first 3 pairs and after 2 orbitals are unpaired electron, but 4s orbital there is no any electron because of nickel plus 2, na this 2 electrons are removed. In 4p orbital, as usual empty orbital. After that, my dear students, the most important key point is nickel 2 plus ion under the influence of strong CN ligand. Ipo already I said clearly, ipo strong ligands whenever approaching to the central metal atom, definitely central metal atom electrons are pair up. Now here 2 unpaired electrons present in the 3D orbital in nickel atom, na up NH, this here 4 ligands are approaching to this unpaired electrons are pair up. Ipo pair up, na this last electron shifting to here, hence 4 pair of electrons are present in the nickel plus 2 ion 3D orbital. Now hence, my dear students, after pair up of the electron in this 3D orbital, after pair up of the unpaired electron in this 3D orbital, one vacant orbitals are formed. See carefully, one vacant orbital, upper manga or s orbital, here 2p orbital, because of 4 ligands are approaching to the nickel. That's why nickel provided 4 unpaired electron, 4 vacant orbital. So 4 vacant orbital, after pair up of the unpaired electron from the 3D orbital, 1 vacant orbitals are there. After that 4s orbital 1 and 4p orbital 2. This is not required because of 4 it's enough. So that's why this hybridization from the d orbital one orbital, s orbital 1, p orbital 2. These 4 1 are intermixing, involved in the hybridization, hence to form dsp2 hybrid orbital. This is called dsp2 hybrid orbital. So okay, Nana. So why here first d orbital are involved? Because of whenever ligands are approaching to the central metal atom, especially strong ligand, then the central metal atom pair up of unpaired electron. Hence, one vacant orbital is formed. So this one vacant orbital, s orbital and remaining 2 p orbital are intermixing to form the new hybrid orbital. That hybrid orbital name is a dsp2 hybrid orbital. This is the dsp2 hybrid orbital. And additionally, p orbital, from the p orbital one extra orbital is there. This orbital is not involved in the hybridization. After that, here in this 3D orbital, listen carefully, in the 3D orbital, all all orbital are completely paired with the electron. There is no any unpaired electron. Hence, in this DSP2 new hybrid orbital, 4 pair of electron from the 4 cyanide ligands. So now 4 cyanides donated one lone pair of electron to central metal atom. That pair of electron directly enter into this DSP2 hybrid orbital. Hence, this square planar complexes are formed. This is the structure of the square planar. So nickel CN 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 2 minus. So because of here, net charge is the 2 minus. Now see carefully, my dear students. Any unpaired electrons are present in these complexes? No, there is no any unpaired electron. These are completely paired. That's why this complex is the diamagnetic complexes. See, my dear students, tetracyanonickelate 2 ion are the tetracyanonickelate 2 ion are the diamagnetic behavior because of there is no any unpaired electron. So this compound from the square planar complexes. Clear, ma? Now one more example from the square planar structure, that is called tetracyanocuprate 2 ion. It's very, very special. It's a very, very, very special compound. See carefully, every student. See, the oxidation state of the copper in this complex is +2. Listen carefully, every student. The oxidation state of the copper in this complex is +2. During the formation of these complexes, it is believed that the only unpaired 3D electron of Cu2+ ion gets promoted to one of the 4p orbital, thus making available one vacant d orbital, the Cu2+ ion, therefore undergoes DSP2 hybridization and to form square planar structure and paramagnetic behavior. See carefully in the structure, Nana. Copper, generally you know that very well, its copper show abnormal electronic configuration, 3d10 4s1. Now in this copper 3d orbital 10 electrons are there, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, and 4s orbital only one unpaired electron. Now after copper lose the two electron, it show Cu plus 2 oxidation state na enna here from the 4s orbital one electron irukana, this one electron, and from the 3d orbital one more electron is eliminated. Appo enna here 3d orbital has only one unpaired electrons are there. 3d orbital has only one unpaired electrons are there. Now here special nana, this one unpaired electron gets promoted to 4p orbital. So here onwards it's migrated to the 4p orbital. That is the most important. Here in the 3d orbital only one unpaired electron. So here it's not possible to pair up. Already remaining all electrons are paired. There is not possible to pair up. That's why this electron gets promoted to the one of the 4p orbital. That is the reason. But in this case, two unpaired electrons irukana, it's a pair up is possible because of this one electron is joining to pair up of this electron. But here only one unpaired electron, it's not possible to the pair up. Even strong ligand also present here, it's not possible to the pair up because of there is no any another unpaired electron. That's why, my dear student, this one unpaired electrons are get promoted to the one of the 4p orbital. So that's why this one electron is completely shifted to the 4p orbital. See carefully, here is there. Up here one vacant orbital from the 3D, one vacant orbital, from 4S, one vacant orbital, from the 4P, two vacant orbital. These four orbital are intermixing to form DSP2 hybridization, new DSP2 hybridization. See, this promoted electron already present in the 4P orbital. They are not involved in the any kind of the hybridization. Keep it in your mind now. After that, in the 3D orbital, completely paired is there, But this last electron, listen carefully my dear student, here look like as the 3D orbital completely paired. If you, sir, here completely paired, sir, that's why is a diamagnetic substance, na? No, already 3D orbital already promoted into the 4P orbital. So these unpaired electrons are belongings to the actually 3D orbital. That's why here in these complexes unpaired electrons are present. That's why it is a paramagnetic, because of one unpaired electron is promoted to the 4p orbital. It means that unpaired electron present in the copper metal. That's why nana it's considered as a unpaired electron, not a paired electron. So that's why it is a paramagnetic behavior. After that, see, in the 3D orbital completely paired is there. Aparama DSP2 hybrid orbital. DSP2 hybrid orbital filled with 4 pair of the ligand electron and 4P orbital 1 unpaired electrons are there. So this is the structure of this compound. CN taken 4 time. The compound name is a tetracyanocuprate 2. So this is the paramagnetic ma. Now you will don't see here the entire the combination, you will see 4p orbital contain one unpaired electron. So it is a paramagnetic substances. Okay, my dear students, in my last 3 classes I successfully completed the complete information regarding to VBT theory, valency bond theory. So postulations and also how to formation of the complex compound from the coordination number 6 and coordination number 4. In the coordination number 6 octahedral manner, coordination number 4 tetrahedral complexes and square complexes. And my next class I will go to discuss valency bond theory limitations. Okay ma'am?